Hello everyone, welcome to the next class on the probability theory. Today we will discuss the one of the most important part in the probability and statistics, that is called as the Bayes theorem. So we will see the proof of the Bayes theorem. So you will very surprised that I just summarized this in the three lines. So the proof of this Bayes theorem is given in the three lines. So myself, Dr. Gar, given in working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute. So what we have studied in the last three lectures are there, that is the independent event, conditional and the total probability. So based on these three lectures, we will study an important application of this called as the Bayes theorem. And the link of these three videos are already given in the description and you can click on that to watch the videos. So what is the Bayes theorem? Is that Bayes theorem was initially given by the British mathematician, that's called as Thomas Bayes in 1763. What he was proposed that he usually update the prior probabilities based on the some given informations and then calculate their reversing probability. What is the meaning is that if you have some prior probabilities, it means some probabilities are given to you about the events, then some new information is imposed on the condition, on this statement, then you will apply the Bayes theorem. Once you will apply the Bayes theorem, then you will calculate the some new probability, that call as the posterior probabilities. So that's the basic task of this Bayes theorem, that is start from the prior probabilities, some new condition, some new information is given to you, that is based on the conditional, and apply this Bayes theorem on this new information, and then we will calculate the posterior probabilities. So what is the proof? Is quite simple. So what is the Bayes theorem stated to you that? So it states that if there are some disjoint events, A1, A2 and AN are my disjoint events, such that the probability is a non-zero, then for any event A, which is nothing but the subset of the union, then the probability of this AI, given that this event E happens, is nothing but this one. So the proof is very easy. So let's see the proof in just in the three lines. Okay, so what is the given statement is that? So it is given that A1, A2, AN are mutually disjoints. So what is the meaning of the mutually disjoints? It means A1 intersection A2 intersection A3 are all 5. A1 intersection A2 is also 5 and so on. And what about their union is? Yes, union is the complete sample space. So I just firstly draw the figure of this mutually disjoints. Look at that. This is my set A1, this is A2, this is A3, this is A4 and so on. These are my AN and this is my complete sample spaces. So these are my disjoints. Okay. What is again given to you that an arbitrary set E, which is a subset of, what is that? E is the subset of union of AIs. That is the meaning is that. So it means this is my A. So what is the union is S. So E is basically, what is that? E is nothing but the subset of the S. So you can draw any subset, look like this. I just draw the subset of this. Okay, so this brown color is my E. And what is given to you else is nothing. So you have to prove that. Now look at this statement carefully, what you have. So it is given to E is the subset of this. So I can start with this. E is the subset of this. So I can write this E as nothing but E. Because if I say A is the subset of B, what it means that A is nothing but A intersection B. So B, with the base this rule, so I can write this one. Okay. So based on this, I can take U as out, union is outside and so on. So look at that. What is that? What is the E intersection? So this is my E intersection A1. Fine. This is my E intersection AN. Okay, look at that. What is that? This is this small portion, that is called as the E intersection of this set. What is the E intersection of A2? This is my E intersection of A2. Okay, and so on. So, and for example, this case, this is the E intersection of this whole is the E intersection of this set. Okay, so that's the meaning of this. And if you join them, okay, is it from E? Yes, because the joining of this and this, it itself form a set E. Now look at that, what is the meaning of that? So now what is the E intersection AI? So E intersection AI, that is this portion, if you again see that that is this portion, this is nothing but the subset of, this is the subset of A1, this is the subset of A2, okay. And can you see that this portion all are independent, are all disjoints? Yes, okay, they are all are disjoints. So this is my line number 1, okay. Now think about that E intersection A is B. So what is that? Now since they are the disjoints, so you can take the probability on the both side. Okay, so what will happen if you take the probabilities on both sides? So probability of the union is nothing but the summation of the probabilities. So now what is that? So what is the probability of E intersection AI? You know that what is the probability of A intersection B? This is nothing but the probability of BA condition probability of this, or you can also write this as probability of B multiply probability of A condition B. So look at that, in this line probability of EI is given to you. Okay, so probability of EI is given to you, so you can write this as probability of EI's condition E condition AI's. Okay, now rest is over. So now you need to start from here because your target is to here. So now you can apply the definition of the conditional probability on this. What is the A condition B? A intersection B divided by this. So in the this is my line number 2 and this is my line number 3. So what is the value of the P of E? So this I can substitute here, and for this numerator side again I can write this as what is the A condition A intersection B probability of A conditional probability of this. So that's the quiet proof of this Bayes theorem. So look at that, this is the Bayes theorem. Okay, so I hope you can simply learn that. Now some remark about this conditional probability. So look at that, how many probabilities are associated with this formula? One is this, which are highlighted in this pink color, and since this AI are known to you in advance, so that's why this is called as the prior probability, because they exist before we gain any information. Any other probabilities given to you? This one, second one, this is given to you. So this is the conditional probability of E when AI happened. So that is called as the likelihood. Why? Because they indicates how likely the event E occurs for the given each, what are AIs are my prior probabilities, for when given AIs are prior probabilities. Any other probabilities given to you? This is the prior probability. This A condition EI is a likelihood. So this condition is there. So one more probability is given to you. So what is that probability suggest to that? It means, what is the meaning of this? This means you have to calculate the probability of AIs. You have to calculate the probability of AI given that E occurred. What is the meaning of that? Since probability of AI is already occurred. Okay, probability of AI is already occurred. But right now you have to calculate the probabilities of AI under the condition that E occurs. It means you have to update the probabilities of the initial values. So that means this is called as the posterior probability, because they are determined after the results of the experiments are known. So that's the simple meaning of these three probabilities. So if you look at that meaning of this again, look at that the conditional meaning of this. You have the given probabilities, these are my P of AIs. You have some new information, that is the probability of E. Apply the Bayes theorem, then you will calculate the, you have to update the probabilities of AIs with the help of probabilities of E. So that's the quite simple 3-line proof is there. So I hope you can learn this. So we will see more examples related to the Bayes theorem in our next lecture. Till then you can think about the proof again very carefully about that. If you find any other videos regarding any probability subjects or statistics there, you can browse this YouTube channel link. Till then, best of luck.